स्टैंडर्ड 9 वेलकम बैक इन मैथ्स 2 दिस इज स्टैंडर्ड 9 वी आर डूइंग नाउ द फोर्थ लेसन रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर एक्सरसाइज 4.1 फाइंड द रेशियो क्वेश्चन 1 फाइंड द रेशियो of first to second find the ratio of first to second 2 means this will be upon so in that simple questions I will take Question number 1, in that the second one I will take, that is 38 to 57. Ratio equal to, required ratio equal to 38 upon 57. Division means ratio, 19 to the 38, 19 3 the 57. So ratio is equal to 2:3. 2:3. So in this only one question I am going to take. So you should know what it is. That's it. Now I will change. Question number 2 now. In question number 2, in that the second one, rupees 14 and rupees 12 paise 40. Rupees 12 paise 40. So now everything this is rupees and paise so I have to convert them in the same unit this is rupees and paise no this I will convert into paise this also I will convert into paise so rupees 14 is equal to 14 into 100 that is equal to 1400 paise paise 1400 so rupees 12 paise 40 is equal to 12 into 100 this will be all total paise 12 into 100 this will be of 12 plus this 40 paise plus 40 That is equal to paise, this is 1200 and this is 40, so 1240. So, ratio, required ratio. Is equal to, first to second only, so 1400 upon 1240. This 0 cut, 0 cut. By 4 I can divide this. So 4 3 are 12, 4 1s are 4 3 are 12, 2 5s are. So this ratio is equal to 35:31. This is the ratio. So always convert them into the same units. Another one I will take. 5 liters and 2500 ml. These liters I have to convert to ml. Either this convert or convert this to liter. If I want to convert this into liter, I will divide by 1000. If I want to convert this liters into ml, I will multiply by 1000. 5 liters equal to 5 into 1000 ml. So that is equal to 5000 ml. Now the ratio, required ratio, is equal to first to second. This is 5000 to 2500. Zero cut, zero cut. 25 ones are, 25 twos are. So that is equal to 2 is to 1. These are the simple questions. So I am not going to explain it in detail. Then the fourth one. 3 years, 4 months. And 5 years, 8 months. Yes, 8 months. All I have to convert into the months. So this 3 years, 4 months is equal to 1 year means 12 months. 3 years means 3 into 12 plus this 4 months. These are all months. So 12 is 36. 36 plus 4, 40 months. Now this also I will convert. 5 years, 8 months is equal to 5 into 12 plus this 8, and this will be months. 12 is 60, this is 68 months. Now the ratio, required ratio, is equal to first to second will be 40 upon 68. If it is stated second to first, then 68 upon 40. Now by whether I can divide by 4, yes I can divide by 4. 4 tens are, 4 ones are 4, remains 2, 4 sevens are 28, and that ratio is, this is equal to 10 is to 17. Similarly for kg also, we have to multiply by 1000, and here I will end this question. Question number 2, I will end remaining questions. I have kept for you, do the assignment on it. So, express the ratio in reduced form. Question 3. Express the following percentage in the reduced form. Express in the reduced form. Reduced form. First is 75%. So in the question it is given 75, 100, that it is given. So I have to reduce it. So this will be 75% or 75 upon 100. So 75 is to 100, it is given like this, this way. So is to is equal to 75 upon 100. 25 3 the, 25 4 the, and that is equal to 3 is to 4. Now the third one I will take. Third one is 6.25%. Percents means upon 100. Percents means upon 100. So this is equal to 6.25 upon 100. Now to remove these two decimals, I will shift these two decimals here. This point. Then here it is also a decimal point. This also I will shift for two places. So this will be 6.25 upon this 100 into for this 200. Now by 25 I can 25 is 625 because 25 square is 625. 25 fours are. Now 25 ones are and 25 fours are. So that is equal to 1 upon 16. And that is equal to 1:16. Hope that you have understood this. So the fifth one also I will take. Fifth is 0.64%. Percent is upon 100. So 0.64 upon 100. This is the meaning of this percent. Percent means upon 100. So I have to bring it here by two decimal places. So 64 upon this 100. And for these two decimals, I will write into 100. So by 4 I can. 4 ones are 4. 4 so remains 2. 4 6 are 24. 4 25 are. Again by 4 I can. 4 4 are and 4 25 are. So this is 4 upon 625. So that ratio is 4:625. So these are all these basic questions. Okay. Now the fourth one I will solve it afterwards and I will solve this question 5. Convert into percentage. Number 1 is 15:25. Percentage means upon 100 it is needed. So that is equal to 15 upon 25. So here I want 100. So what I will do, I will multiply this by 4. So that is equal to 15 upon 25 into 4 into 4. Numerator and denominator is multiplied by 4. That is equal to 15 for the 60 upon 100. Upon 100 means percentage, so that is equal to 60%. If suppose some of the students don't understand, so what I will do is, I will give you another method. So 15:25 is equal to 15 upon 25. I have to convert into percentage. So that is equal to 15 upon 25 into 100 and this is the percentage. Immediately give the sign of percentage. So 25 ones are 25 fours are, that is equal to 60%. So this is a very simple method. Just multiply by 100 and give the symbol of percentage. Don't forget this symbol, otherwise it is wrong. So the second one is 47:50. So that is equal to 47 upon 50. That is equal to 47 upon 50 Here I have to make into 2. Here also I will make into 2. So that is equal to 94 upon 100. And upon 100 means percentage. That is equal to 94%. Or 47 is to 50 is equal to 47 upon 50. I have to convert into percentage. So 47 upon 50 into 100 and immediately give the symbol of this. So this zero cut, 5 ones are 5 twos are, and that is equal to 94%. So now here onwards, whatever method you feel better, you do it. So, the fourth one, 546 is to 600. So this I will do it as it, that is equal to 546 upon 600. I have to make it 100. So that is equal to 546, this is 600. If I divide it by 100, by 6, then it will become 100. So divide this also by 6. So that is equal to, so now divide it by this, by what we are dividing? By 6. So 6 9s are 54, 6 1s are 6, and this will be 100, and that is equal to 91%. Or also I am solving for you to make a practice. So 546 is to 600 is equal to 546 upon 600 into 100%. Zero cut, zero zero cut. 6 ones are, 6 91s are. And that is equal to direct answer, you have got 91%.
Okay.
So now the fifth sum, 7 upon 16. By what I have to multiply 7 upon 16? Yeah, that way only it is given. So this is equal to 7 upon 16 upon, I want 100 upon, there is no, so into also I will do 100. So that is equal to this 700 upon 16 upon this 100. If I divide this 700 by 16, so first of all I will reduce this. By 4 I can reduce. 4 4 is 16. 4 1 is 4. Remains 3. 0. 4 7 is 28. 2 4 5 is 20. So 175 upon 4. This is equal to 175 upon 4 upon 100. Now divide this 175 upon 4. So 175 divided by 4, 4 4 is 16, remains 1, take 5, 4 3 is 12, remains 3. Now I cannot divide. So give the decimal and take the point, take the 0, 4 7 is 28, remains 2, take 0, 4 5 is 20. So what is that division? This division is, that is equal to 43.75 upon 100. Upon 100 means percentage. So that is equal to 43.75%. So this is the answer. I will do the OR method also. This OR method, 7 upon 16 is equal to 7 upon 16 into 100 per sex. So that is equal to, this will be 700 upon 16. Now as usual, divide. 4 za, 4 1 za, 4 7 za, 4 5 za. 175 upon 4. And that division was 43.75 per sex. So whichever the method is better for you, you can do it. So, there is another question number 4 now. Question 4. 3 persons can build a small house in 8 days. 3 persons can build a house in 8 days. In 8 days. Full stop. To build the same house in 6 days, In 6 days, how many days are required? How many persons are required? Now, what is this question? That first of all, we have to see ratio and proportion, how it has entered in ratio and proportion, that I have to see. Solution. In 8th standard, you have seen the variation. This is the question based on variation. You have solved such question. 3 persons, 8 days. So, for 6 days, how many persons? So, now persons and work. These persons and the days required. If 3 persons are there, 8 days are required. Means 8 days correspond to 3 persons. Now 6 days means days have been reduced. 8 days require 3 persons. Now the days have increased or reduced. Earlier 8, see this, days. Persons. Days 8. Persons 3. Now in 6 days I have to build the house. How many persons are required? X persons are required. This is the table. So what will happen if the number of the days are reduced? If the number of the days are reduced, the persons will increase. That means it is an inverse variation. It is an inverse variation. Days reduce, persons will increase. Days more, persons will be less. So it is the inverse variation. In inverse variation, the product is constant. In inverse variation, the product is constant. Which product? This product and this product. So therefore, this product will be 6 into x is equal to 8 into 3. This product and this product is constant, means it is equal. Therefore, x is equal to 8, 3 the 24 upon 6, 6 1 the 6, 4 the. Therefore, x is equal to how much? 4. So how many persons are required? 4 persons are required. So the remaining videos, the remaining questions we will solve in the next video. Another 3-4 questions are remaining. 3 questions are remaining, and those are the word problems. The students are always suffering for the word problems. We will give some proper time. So, up to what questions we have done? Question 1 to question 5 we have done. Now the 6 onwards we will do in the separate video. Okay, good night all of you. Do it properly.